The next presenter is Antonio, who already has a PhD in electronics and is also now a PhD student in management and business. He's a researcher in sensors, machine learning, and public health management at the University of Rome San Rafael. Please, Antonio, let's hear your presentation.
Thank you for the introduction. Oh, sorry. Thank you for the introduction, Chair. The study that I will show you today is an application of the machine learning techniques in the healthcare field through the voice signal, and I have added also the handwriting signal. So these are results published in other journals, but is an ongoing project to mix the two models. Please, next slide. Starting from the voice signal, we could collect the data from a simple smartphone and a simple application, in this case in the Android software. After that, we could collect the data locally in the device, and we can redirect the data on a web platform. The graph show a differences between health subject and unhealthy subject. In this case, we choose the Parkinson's disease that has vocal impairment during the symptoms. We collect about 50 subjects, and we decide a protocol for the vocal emission and also for the phrases. This is, could be a problem if we choose an Italian model or another language model, because the vocal is an international protocol, but the phrases change country by country. So in this case, we obtain with this model, with KNN, an accuracy of 97%, that is very high for our mission to distinguish healthy and unhealthy for a machine, for a software machine. Next slide, please. Thank you. Another application of the machine learning is the using of the handwriting signal. We started from a chat database, as in the literature, and we defined different protocols for the Italian phrases, and also a new graph protocol. We obtain, in this case, starting from about 80 subjects, so it's a lot of subjects for the model, and about 10 observations for each subject, a lower accuracy than the literature, but we use a subset of tasks, only two subsets, a spiral for the graph part and the LE for the handwriting part. In the future development, we hope to integrate these models, these machine learning models, starting from different software as Unity, MATLAB, and so on, into the Clari infrastructure. Next slide, please. Thank you. This is an ending slide starting from the scene language using a wearable sensor, in this case, inertial sensor. This is due for people that has vocal impairment, so they can use only the gesture, only the finger, and so on. So we can translate the hand gesture, the forearm movement in a signal language. And also in this case, we would apply the machine learning technique, and we hope also to integrate in the Clari infrastructure. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much. Again, please enter your questions or comments directly in chat. And in the meantime, we're moving on to Zainab.